Did you know almost 30 million tons of aluminum are recycled globally every year? That's almost 2 trillion aluminum cans worth of aluminum that's recycled. It actually has a global efficiency rating of 76%, which means it is highly recyclable. It means that it's often cheaper to use a recycled version of aluminum than anything else, which is why it's one of the best materials that you can use because it can be reused so easily. So today we're talking about what types of metals can be recycled, what that looks like, and obviously we'll highlight aluminum because that's what we do. We're gonna start first with steel, which is one of the most recycled metals globally, with a recycle rate of over 90% for some products. So how does that process work? See, first there's collection and then sorting. There's 2 different ways you can collect metal. One is pro-consumer and the other is post-consumer. Essentially, once it's made into a good that a consumer can use, it's post-consumer. So pro-consumer is gonna be stuff that we do. So as we manufacture, we have scrap that comes off. Steel is like that when it comes to most construction sites, demolition, that sort of thing. Post-consumer is gonna be like appliances or anything that you take to a local scrapyard or see in like a junkyard of cars, that would all be post-consumer steel. On the second step of sorting, what they're gonna use are magnets because steel is a ferrous metal or a magnetic metal. And so the important part there is to use magnets to pull them up. They actually have conveyor belts which will roll small parts along the conveyor and then another inverted conveyor belt above it that is magnetic so that it will then lock the parts up above and they can rotate in 2 opposite directions. And so therefore sorting the steel from anything that is non-ferrous or non-magnetic. The next step is processing, and that's all about getting the parts as small as possible so that they melt a lot easier. And so that's gonna be compacting. Those are your fancy car compactors that everyone has always seen. That's also shredding, where they'll actually take like fridges and drop them in and shred the whole thing like a giant blender. And that's all about, again, getting them as small as possible so that they melt easily. And speaking of melting, that's the next step. So they basically are going to melt all the parts down into a liquid version of the metal. And that's gonna be typically either with an electric arc furnace or a basic oxygen furnace, both of which achieve the same result, which is molten metal. Interesting fact, when you recycle 1 ton or 2,000 pounds of steel, you actually save 1,400 pounds of coal and 120 pounds of limestone. Another commonly recycled metal is copper. And I think that's the most famous of the recycled metals. It's the one people know about. It's the one dubious people know about in terms of stealing from houses. See, copper is really valuable as a resource and as a metal for a couple reasons. One, it's primarily used for pipes, and it's also commonly used for wiring because it is so conductive of electricity. So the primary sources of a recycled copper are going to be the things that I already covered, which is plumbing, wiring, and also consumer electronics that have a lot of copper inside them. The next step with copper is the same as with steel, and that's sorting. Now, this is also a really cool way that they sort through copper. So copper is diamagnetic, which means it repels magnetic field. So imagine a conveyor, and underneath that conveyor is going to be a spinning rod. And on that rod, there are 2 opposite magnetic poles, north and south, which are your magnetic poles. And as it spins, the metal goes over the conveyor, and near the end of the conveyor, that spinning magnet actually will push or repel the copper, or the copper will be repelled by the magnetic field rather, and it will shoot off onto a separate conveyor where everything else that's non-ferrous then falls through. And this is called an eddy current. So it helps separate the copper from the other non-ferrous types metals. Some facilities actually use the same method for sorting aluminum. So the next step here is gonna be processing. And so for processing, it's really cool with copper. What they do is they essentially have to smelt it first, but when you smelt it, you get an impure version of copper. So it's copper with zinc and gold and silver and all these other metals all into this sheet. So what they do is they take a sheet of pure copper and a sheet of impure copper, and they drop them into a copper sulfate jar. Imagine, it's obviously much larger. And then they pass a current through it. And so what it does is, the concept is, the copper sulfate is basically a solution, imagine a solution of copper or water copper, okay? And what happens is when they pass that current, that water copper or that copper that's dissolved in the water will get attracted to the pure copper sheet. And so that pure copper sheet will slowly get bigger. To replace the copper in the solution, imagine salt water where it wants to retain its certain level of saltiness, okay? The copper that's on the impure sheet will slowly move into the water or dissolve into the water to replace the copper water, or whatever copper was in the water, that moves over to the pure copper sheet, and therefore taking the impure one slowly into the solution and then over to the pure one. And then what drops off is all the old metals that aren't copper, and they sit at the bottom as a sludge. That is how they process copper to a pure copper that you can actually use in wires or pipes. And this process is called electrolysis. And then that processed pure copper is then formed into parts that can otherwise be used either through rolling, through drawing, or through casting. And copper, in this case, is also much like aluminum, meaning that it can be recycled indefinitely. It doesn't lose its purity over the many cycles of recycling that it goes through. And a fun fact is that 80% of all the copper that's ever been mined is still in use today. So highly recyclable, highly valuable, and highly useful. The next subset here is going to be precious metals. And so that's going to be gold, silver, and platinum, the shiny things that people like to wear in jewelry. These metals are primarily collected through electronic waste, like computer motherboards or graphics cards. The way they sort these precious metals that are hidden within the electronics is they have to crush it the same way they crush most of the other stuff we talked about with steel. But in this case, they have to remove anything dangerous that is going to cause issues in the crushing process, like batteries that tend to explode when you try and crush them, or glass and TVs that can otherwise cause problems to the machinery. So all these electronics are then basically crushed into these tiny little bits, and then that's going to be sorted using the same sort of things we talked about before, and that's going to be magnets, eddy currents, and also through AI sortation, where it visually looks at what is there, makes the correct assumption based on pattern recognition, and then gets rid of things that aren't the things that you're looking for, in this case, like precious metals. An interesting fact is that circuit boards are really dense in precious metals like copper and gold, because they conduct electricity really well. So if you took an ore, basically a mined ore of its respective type, in this case, let's say gold, and you took that ore, a metric ton of that ore, and compared it to a metric ton of circuit boards, you may actually have 40 to 800 times more gold, or 30 to 40 times more copper than you would of its respective metric ton of ore. So interesting that they're highly dense, or the phone in your pocket is highly dense in the precious metals, more so than ore that you could mine out of the earth. So the next topic is going to be aluminum, which is obviously a topic that we get into a lot. We recycle a lot of the aluminum that we use as we are making our product. Now, aluminum can also be indefinitely recycled without losing any of its purity, just like copper. And that's essentially what we do. So as we make things, we recycle aluminum, and a lot of the aluminum that we use that comes into us as a finished part is recycled, or any of the pergolas that we sell are highly made out of recycled aluminum. So the process of recycling aluminum, the first step is going to be collection and preparation. So aluminum is collected the same way steel is, which is pro and post-consumer. And so on the pro side, you're going to have any manufacturing, that's going to be any job sites, it's going to be any people like us that make a product that's highly made out of aluminum, windows, that sort of thing. Post-consumer, the most famous one is going to be aluminum cans. Everyone can think of aluminum recycling as the, you know, the carts full of aluminum cans, or the bags full of aluminum cans, or the recycling options you have at any food venue where you can recycle the aluminum cans. Also, vehicle parts and demolition sites have a lot of aluminum. Now, aluminum is going to be sorted similarly as all the other metals. You have a conveyor with the inverted conveyor over the top to remove any ferrous metals. You have the eddy current, which is going to shoot off any of the diamagnetic materials. And then you're going to have that same sort of optical search where they can use either AI or any sort of technology they have to get rid of any other non-metals. The first step of processing is going to remove any paint or coatings. And so what they're going to do is essentially heat up the aluminum just enough to the point where they bake off or vaporize any of the paint that's adhered to the aluminum, but not enough to actually melt the aluminum yet. That comes next. The second step of processing is melting the aluminum. So they're going to melt the whole thing in a giant furnace, similarly to steel. And in this case, they're also going to have an oxide layer on the top, because as aluminum, especially at high temperatures, meets oxygen, it's going to turn into aluminum oxide. Just as iron oxide is rust, everyone knows about rust, aluminum oxide is just a black or gray version of the same thing. So they skim off the aluminum oxide as they melt it down. And in the end, they'll pour out that pure aluminum into molds. So then they're going to take that mold and they're going to use it for whatever respective purpose it's going to next, either rolling it out into some sort of sheet aluminum, or they're going to melt it with other metals to make alloys, which is where you get into aluminum alloys that we use. And the interesting fact about aluminum is that recycled aluminum actually requires only 5% of the energy it would take to make the same amount of aluminum out of bauxite ore. And for more information about that process and bauxite ore and all that, you can see our video on history of aluminum up here. So how does that relate to us? How do we use recycled aluminum, and how do we actually then feed back into the same system? So all our products are custom to whatever you want. So we have standard sizes, but we also have custom sizes to the half inch. And so if you're buying a product from us, we have to buy it in a certain lineal length, and we're gonna cut off whatever you don't want out of that size. That not wanted portion of aluminum is then gonna go into a bin or a hopper. We're gonna put it in that hopper, we're gonna build it up, and then we're gonna have a recycler that we use locally, that's a local business, that comes here and takes all that aluminum from us in a giant bin. Now, it is important that we do the sorting for them. So if we have some stainless parts or some steel parts, we do not mix that with the aluminum extrusions. But the fun part for us is about 10% of all the aluminum we receive goes right back out to get recycled, because by and large, you guys want certain sizes, and that means that our yield is about 90%. Nothing gets thrown away. So that's obviously how we recycle, and that plays into the whole system. All this allows us to have less waste, and in a lot of ways, a cheaper product in the end for you. You see, recycling all these metals can reduce up to 300 to 500 million tons of CO2 that otherwise would be used if we didn't use these recycling processes globally for all these different metals. So that's recycled metals. That's how we use it. That's the sort of processing that it goes through. So if you wanna see more about how our product is recycled or how it's used, obviously you can see that down below. And if you want a really cool product that's made primarily out of recycled aluminum, you can check out our website at theluxurypergola.com. Otherwise, let us know what you guys think about this video, if there's anything else you want us to cover. We'll see you in the next one.